Now we're going to look at kinematics in a slightly different way, or rather a different application. And so walking or running or one of those two activities. And so typically we describe strides when we run or walk and steps. So typically in the literature, one stride is equal to two steps. Okay, and here's the step for walking our speed, race walking, running, sprinting. Okay, the white is swing phase and the dark is stance phase. So basically one stride is from left heel contact to the following left heel contact. Okay, one step is from left heel contact to right heel contact. The next step is right heel contact to left heel contact. So two steps make a stride. Now the key to remember for walking and running is typically you spend 60% of your time of a full stride in walking in the stance phase, so you're touching the ground, and 40% in the swing phase, where you're advancing your limb forward. Typically running, although this is pretty fast running, typically running is the reversed. So it would be 40 stance, 60 swing. In this case, at this speed, they're saying it's 30% of your time is in stance phase, or with one foot in contact with the ground, and 70% in the float phase or swing phase. Okay, so two steps equal a stride, and it's a 60-40 split between stance and swing for walking, and a 40-60 or a 30-70, depending on the speed of running, stance phase to swing phase for running. And then you can see sprinting is even less time. So those sprinters are basically floating rather than running. All right, a few more definitions. A stride, as I said, defined as two steps, one motion cycle, approximately one hertz for walking. And a hertz is just a cycle per second. All right, so we're doing one cycle per second. Stride length is the distance from heel to heel or toe to toe. I tend to like going heel contact to heel contact, but obviously if you're doing a sprinter who contacts with their forefoot, then you would do toe to toe for a stride length. It's usually measured in meters or centimeters. Obviously, for human motion, meters makes a little bit more sense. The stride time is the duration of time that it took you to take that stride. So 1 second, half a second and a half, whatever it is, that would be your stride time. Stride rate is the inverse of stride time. It's 1 over stride time. It can also be measured in hertz, cycles per second, or strides per second. Okay, stride speed or velocity, speed and velocity are sometimes used interchangeably, is you can calculate it by taking your stride length times your stride rate, or your stride length divided by your stride time. And velocity, as we learned before, is meters per second. So you don't need to have a clock, really, to measure how fast they're running. You could count, you can measure their stride length, figure out their stride rate or their stride time, and calculate velocity. All right, and then step cadence or cadence is stride rate times 120, which is two steps times 60 seconds per minute. So a lot of times when we deal with cadence, it's beats per minute or steps per minute. So people say, oh, I have 180 steps per minute. So that's not looking at strides, but each footfall. And so there's a lot of talk in the blogosphere and then in the scientific literature about the optimal cadence for runners. And if speeding up your cadence or slowing down your cadence affects the force production at footfall, and then if you increase or decrease your force at foot contact, that could have implications for injury. So I will leave you with this. Is this a step from 1 to 6, or is that a stride?